several events off campus at UBC, including the Friends of Chamber Music competition that we played in about a month and a half ago. At that competition, we were asked a question. And it's not a question that we are not used to by now. And it's probably, at the very least, the question my dad is thinking, which is, why on earth are the two smallest people in the quartet playing the two biggest instruments? I think Mia hears that just about everywhere we go. And that goes as far back as our very first thing that we ever did as a quartet, which was a masterclass with Kenneth Che 2 years ago. And it's funny, none of us remember anything about that masterclass except for that he came up to us and looked at Mia and looked at Mo and said, you two should be switching instruments. And to this day, we still get it everywhere we go. I don't think, Mia, I'm sorry, you're going to have to be like used to it for the rest of ever. I think for me, at least, the Barry Sax was the first instrument that felt like it belonged to me. When I was in elementary band and high school band, I switched instruments a lot, asked my parents, and it wasn't until ninth grade when I started playing Barry Sax that I really found an instrument that felt right. It was a strange feeling being a Barry Sax player in a concert band in ninth grade because you sit with the tuba player and the contrabass clarinet player and the euphonium player, and it's a totally different world back there. But it's a world that is kind of calming because in a lot of ways you are the foundation that an ensemble is based on. You play the bass line, and that's almost the second most important thing to the melody. I don't get to play Barry a lot anymore. I mostly play tenor, and that's totally fine by me. The tenor saxophone is very much my voice. But because of how much the Barry Sax shaped me in high school and at Quantum Polytechnic University, where I did the first 2 years of my degree, I never turned down an opportunity to play Barry because it's just so much fun. Speaking of fun, this piece, Black, is powerful, aggressive, in your face. It even says at the bottom, both baritone saxophones may be amplified to give the sound presence and edge. We've chosen not to do that because this room's a little small and it would get a little loud really fast. So I hope you enjoy Black. I would like to let you know that after this piece there will be a 15-minute intermission. So on the live stream, people, don't go anywhere. We'll be back, we promise. And I hope you enjoy Black by Marc. Thank you.